Well, Balibrea is one of the most marginalized area of Honduras, and they're the poorest people. Essentially, they call it the forgotten people of Honduras because they just don't get anything there. There's no education, there's a lot of people that get really sick and all the stuff because they're so poor. If they have one meal a day, they're pretty happy. That's essentially what this place is. It's just a bunch of mountains with a bunch of poor people that can't really seem to get a break. The vision is Noel. He's the one down there doing the work. And he started working with all these people there. And this is, Noel is doing it all on his own with his wife. You name it, he does for that town. Anna, you know, she goes to the church and Noel helps her as much as he can, like with food. He's been putting all the kids to school. What happened with her husband, he just disappeared. So they never heard of him for a long time. So she became a single mother or a widow, she doesn't know. And she started raising her kids on her own. She actually washes clothes, and that's how she's been supporting them. But they live in a very, very small house. That's life for her, but you know, we wanna actually make it a little better for her. So we're in here, and there's a chicken in their bed. So
you said 8 people, but you didn't count the chickens.
Oneida, she, you know, has 4 or 5 kids on her own now, has no way of taking care of them, but just to wash some clothes for some people and say, you know, every other day or whatever, and make some, a little bit of money to eat. She actually had built her own little house, but every time it rained, because it was made of adobe, which is like the clay thing, every time it rained, the water will wash it away. So the very next day, she was there plugging the holes, right? Anna, we will build a house for her in June where it's not gonna be a dirt road anymore. When it rains, the hot water is not gonna go right through the roof. And it's gonna be something very simple, but it's gonna be very practical for them. Ask them, how can I help you with what you know how to do here now? We started her own business too, so which is really good with her youth clothing and all. For her, that was a dream come true. So it was amazing, right? That's incredible. Oneida, she had no idea we were building a house for her. And Noel didn't want to tell her because he didn't want her to feel obligated to go to church and all that stuff. So she became very involved in the church. Just essentially taking leaderships and doing things for their family, women, and all that stuff. And it's incredible. I just think these women just run this town. They're very happy. We're putting all her kids to school. She has a better place to live. She has beds. But it was fun to do it for her because she was very humble. She was very appreciative, you know. You know that she meant it, that she was very, from her heart, that what was happening was a gift, you know. But now she's making good money selling food and taking care of her kids and all that stuff. So it's good. I love it. Eva is a super smart lady. She learned from her grandmother how to deliver kids. And then she became, I guess, the midwife of the town. 3,000 kids she's delivered there. And I think the population of that town is 5,000. Eva, she is the leader of this town. She's amazing. She rallies the troops here like nobody else can. And the reason why we're so well coordinated and all that stuff is because she is like, she gets involved with the community and tells them how they're gonna do things, and people get it done.
Done.
She's amazing. She's also the midwife of the town. Last year alone, she delivered 300, and I'm gonna show you where she delivered them. Come over here. So when we were there, we got to know her. So we asked her, how can we help you? And then she talked with the clinic. Said, I'll look into it to see if we can do something. And then when I talked to Noel, he said, the clinic forever here will be fantastic. The town will all know about it. And then we didn't know that we were going to be able to do all this. You know, we have baby scales. We have everything. Like, it's just incredible. Once this is done, it's going to be really good for her. But we have the clinic, and then we're going to have the, I guess, recovery room. And we already have the cribs. We have the bed for the mother. We have everything there, just ready to be put in. But we're just waiting for the windows and the doors now. She's a good leader in that town, and I think that's what makes that town go around, to be honest. See, with the kids, I guess some of the kids, I would say pretty much 99% of the kids, what they face there is once the kids gets a certain age, a lot of kids end up working just picking coffee, and that's, you know, that's their life. It costs $25 to send a kid to school. And if we can find $25 and say, okay, your little guy can go to school and we'll pay for it. But we need a commitment that he will stay in school and he will finish, you know, the year. Now, we're not going to waste the money. And, you know, so he goes and talks to them and sit down with them and all that stuff. And they're like, you're going to put my kids to school? Because to them, this is huge. So we put 154 kids to school last year. The year before, Noel put 88 kids on his own from help from other people. And right now, as it stands, we have put, like, we have enough money to put 200 kids to school this year. So now this is getting big, because these kids have nothing, absolutely nothing.
Anyway, so this is the class, this is the school. This is where all the kids that we sponsor come.
Very easy just to go and really skip the kids and just do stuff for the town, for the adults and all the stuff, which most people do.
They actually fly in this, you know, with the hope that one day we'll come back and, you know, maybe bring a church team or something just to build them a basketball court and an indoor soccer thing there. Not indoor, but indoor. Just okay. Like a soccer nets little or something, bit.
Yeah. Okay. En nombre del Centro Familiar Cristiano y de esta comunidad, gracias. Vamos a orar. Gracias, Señor, por tu amor y gracias por tu bondad. Gracias, Padre, por el privilegio que nos das de conocer otros hermanos tan especiales. Te damos las gracias, Señor, por el privilegio que nos das de poder servir como esta gente ha venido a servir a personas que ni siquiera conocen. Gracias por enseñarnos por medio de ellos. Nosotros rogamos que tú los bendigas en el nombre de Jesús. También rogamos que tú bendigas, Señor, el viaje que vamos a hacer ahora y que estas personas lleguen con bien a sus familias. Gracias por ellos, en el nombre de Jesús. Amén.
Amén.
Gracias.
Gracias.